Few have analysed the grand finale of the male Lyrebird song more intensively than Dr. Anastasia Dielle. She and her team were the first ones to film it properly.
We thought no one's going to believe us until we've actually filmed it. It's really not like anything else that has been described previously in birds or any other animals.
It was by studying the recordings from their remote camera that the team were able to understand the real secret of the male lyrebird song. And it's this footage, together with our own, that enables us to show this remarkable behaviour on television for the first time. Having sung A, B and C and been rejected, the male now begins song D.
So this final song, it's the sound of a flock of small birds mobbing, reacting to a stationary or a hidden predator like a snake. And this was totally bizarre.
So why is he imitating a flock of birds? Well, a predator means danger. So at the sound of an alarm call, the female freezes. The forest is no longer a safe place. Now the male takes advantage of her panic. He jumps on top of her to mate. It's hard for us to see her under his feathers, and it's hard for her to see out from under them. He's doing everything he can to disorientate and confuse her.
The male is actually telling her a big fib. Don't leave me, because out there, there's a hidden predator that you haven't seen. To put it another way, it's like saying, baby, it's dangerous outside. Come back here with me, where it's nice and safe.
The lyrebird is, in fact, a bird that tells lies. His song is an acoustic illusion. Up to now, scientists had thought that song was an honest signal from the male. But it seems song can also be manipulative and false.